Hello chess friends, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Unfortunately time was not on my side, so I didn't post a video for quite a while. In the last video I mentioned that I will start to present some Soviet chess sets, and this will be the first one. But before I proceed, I just want to say that basically I'm just an enthusiast person that likes to share a hobby with you. I'm not an expert by any means in Soviet chess sets or chess clocks, and the video that will follow are just some reviews of some Soviet chesses that I think are somehow a benchmark for any collector. Some of the information that I will share with you are basically from the website of Chuck Grau, a person that has shared a lot of important information regarding Soviet chess sets, and basically you can find more details regarding this on his website. Today I would like to start by presenting a Soviet chess set which is called the Voronets. As you can see, I have here a folded wooden board, and inside the folded wooden board is the Voronets chess set. The folded wooden board, the size of the folded wooden board is 40 by 40 centimeters, and the size of the square is approximately 45 millimeters. As a brief information regarding the history of this type of chess set, the first chess set called the Voronets, which basically is the town in which the set were manufactured. The first set was manufactured in 1940, just before or even at the start of the Second World War. And after that, all kinds of variants have appeared, and I think the last variants have appeared during the 70s. Unfortunately, the stamp on the box is not very visible, so you cannot date it for sure, which is the exact year of this chess set. But in some cases, the wooden folded board is not very relevant, because the pieces most probably were made in one place or one factory, and the chessboard were manufactured in a different factory, and after that they will be paired and so on. Okay, so I arrange all of the chess pieces, and now I will share some information regarding the Voronets pattern. First of all, the king size is approximately 10 centimeters. In my case, the white and black king have about 99 millimeters, so it's not exactly 10 centimeters in height. The base of the pieces, at least the base of the king and the kings, is about 38 to 40 millimeters. The pawns are about 5.5 centimeters in height, with a smaller diameter as the king and queen. One of the drawbacks of the Voronets pattern is that over time, the base of the pieces are starting to transform from a perfectly round shape into an oval shape. I don't know if this is visible on the camera, but at first, when I saw this chess set first, I was thinking that this is something like a carving error, but during time I found out that this is valid for most of the Soviet chess sets. There are some exceptions, and I will talk about them in the future videos, but in case of the Voronets pattern, in most of the cases this is true. Also, on, let's say, on Baku chess sets you can find this, on Grandmaster sets you can find this drawback, and so on. You can easily identify a Voronets chess set after the shape of the bishops, as the shape of the bishop is somehow totally different from the other chess Soviet patterns. A big question regarding the Voronets pattern is how to identify the period of manufacture of each set. I think that my set is a set that was manufactured in the early to mid 60s. And why I'm saying that? Because during time some of the components of the chess sets have been replaced with plastic. In this, the case of my set, the finals and the king and queen are made from wood, they are not from plastic, but also the knights are entirely made from wood. So that strictly indicates that the set most probably dates from an earlier version. And most probably many of you will say that this is basically will be a 50 set. But this is not the case, because from my documentation I found out that the 50 set have been weighted. In this, the case of my set, the set is not weighted. So basically it doesn't have any lead weights and so on. And the entire weight of the set, without any weights, it's about 480 grams. So that's why I can say for sure that my set most probably is early to mid 60s chess set. It's a very interesting and beautiful set, even though at the beginning when I first seen the set, at the first glance I said, man, this set is quite ugly. But over time you get more and more attached to the Soviet chess sets and you see them through a different light and you start to enjoy them and like them more and more over time. The rooks are very bulky and very nice to move on the board. You can see also that the set has the original felts, which are somehow a pinky color or something like that, and they are relative good quality felts. You can move the chess pieces on the board without feeling any drags and so on. Besides that, the pawns from my point of view are a little bit too small. The bishops, they are the shapes is totally uncommon from my point of view regarding other well-known chess sets, but king and queen are somehow appealing. Maybe this is not some of the most appealing chess Soviet chess sets from my collection, but somehow it's very hard to find. I have watched different kinds of websites like OLX Ukraine, like 1999, Moldova, Avito.Russia, and these type of sets are very scarce and very hard to find, and if you find them, the prices are not low at all. Besides the chess set, I have here on my left side a Soviet chess clock, which basically corresponds with the correct manufacture date of the Voromet chess set. So this chess clock is a Yantak chess clock from the 60s. Basically it has a stamp on the back which says 1963. So basically this chess set is most probably will be seen together with this chess clock in the early to mid 60s. So this is my review regarding the Voronezh pattern. I hope you like the video. In the next video I will try to present a different Soviet chess set which is called the Latvian Mordovian. Most of you know that chess set because of the movie Queen's Gambit. So thank you for watching and see you next time with a different Soviet chess set.